Joining us now is Bayan Muna Portales Representative Ferdinand Gaite. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Yes, good morning, Christian, and good morning to all our viewers.
Okay, that was the version coming from General Parlade that those incidents that took place over the weekend were all part of a legitimate law enforcement operation. But what are the pieces of information that your Portales group has gathered regarding as to what really happened?
Yes, Christian, first, we condemn the Tokhang style incidents that happened. We call it now the Bloody Sunday, you know, wherein at least supposedly nine. We still have the not. We don't have the complete reports, but accordingly from the PNP, they're claiming that nine were killed and several others were arrested. So we only have at least five names as of now, and yet this the scanty reports that we have. This is enough to justify there should be an investigation of what has happened, similar to the drug campaign. There's been this unprecedented killings previously of supposed drug users or pushers. Now the guns are leveled on the heads of activists. And this was very evident in what happened last Sunday in the Southern Tagalog region.
Okay, but so, why were you able, why did you describe that as Tokhang style, those operations?
Yes, similar to what happened before. And even the government has admitted in using the Tokhang style in the Cordillera in other parts of the country under Executive Order Number 70. They claim that they will now be using this same very inhuman way of going after activists by simply claiming that they are left-leaning or front organizations of the CPP, NPA, NDF. They have been harassed, visited in their homes, and as we've seen, search warrants supposedly for explosives or firearms were utilized as basis for the killings and the arrests.
But in this latest round of arrests, what happened based on the information that you got so far? For instance, the five names that you were able to identify based on the police reports, but also based on information coming from the ground, what happened then?
Well, for example, in the Cavite, they have the workers center, workers assistance center or WAC. While the incident was happening, their gates, it was being reported that their gates were being bashed down, was being broken down at 4:30 a.m. or much earlier, and after which supposedly they were posted in their homes, supposedly served a search warrant, and suddenly we believe planted evidences like guns and explosives suddenly appeared from nowhere, and then were arrested. Of course, more seriously were the incidents where they were accosted in their homes. And an example is Manny Asuncion, the leader of Bagong Alianza Makabayan in Cavite, was supposedly, again, nanlaban and was killed in the process. So this is very much similar to the Tokhang style of addressing the supposed drug problem, but okay, now focused on activists and unionists.
Okay, by the way, for the record, we invited the Philippine National Police, the Calabarzon Regional Police Director, the spokesman of the Philippine National Police, to join us in this interview for their official version of the incidents, but unfortunately, they're not available this morning. Now, regarding this incident, you mentioned Manny Asuncion. Let's give a face to this to one of those who were killed in those operations. He is the Secretary General of Bayan in Cavite, right? Is that correct?
That's right.
So how would you describe him aside from that affiliation? Because based on news reports, of course, people might think that this is another communist rebel hiding under the veil of front organization. But what was his record? Who was he?
Well, Manny Asuncion, I met him a couple of times. They invited us to many fora addressing so many basic issues like workers' issues, people's issues. As you know, Cavite hosts the next work processing zone. And many of the workers there in the economic zone face so many concerns, issues of violations of labor rights, the right to organize, the right to basic wages, among others. So we were able to discuss, in so many contractualization, which is also very rampant. So he has been very active in basic concerns of the people in general. Since I was a labor union activist before, we were invited in these conferences to help the workers in fighting for their basic demands. So Manny Asuncion definitely is not a an armed rebel. He is an activist, and he has pursued this through peaceful means of addressing the concerns. Their accusations that he's nanaban, I think this is the old script, the old playbook that they're using, similar to the, as I said, the Tokhang style, nanaban. But definitely, all these accusations are untrue.
Do you think this latest round of police raids that led to the killings of at least 9 people in the region, these were connected to the latest pronouncements of President Duterte?
Definitely. A few days ago, in front of other, I think, members of the AFP, his pronouncements to kill them all is an enabling statement, meaning he essentially is enabling the military, the police, to not ask questions and just kill. And similar to the Tokhang program, many victims are innocents. We have heard how ordinary teenagers who were accosted by the police suddenly turned up dead, like Kian in Nabotas, I believe, or Caloocan. So these enabling statements of Duterte is pushing the military and police to go on a killing spree, a rampage, a massacre, if you can say that. And we believe this is an affront to our basic human rights, the right to life, and okay. It's now rampantly violated.
Now, in the case of Manny Asuncion, what was the version that you received as to what really happened there? How exactly did he allegedly put up a fight?
Well, as I said, we have only scant reports. Even as of yesterday, immediately, many of these incidents happened early in the morning. As I said, we only have 5 names who were supposedly killed in this operations of the PNP. But according to reports, there are 9. A few days before, by the way, a colleague, Ramir Corcolon, the president of the union in San Pablo Water District, was arrested again on trumped up charges, supposedly possession of firearms and explosives. And now they're accusing him of being a member of a gun for hire group. I can't remember the name, ASVAL or whatever. And the narrative of the police and military is that these people supposedly are involved in underground activities. We just saw pictures, by the way, of well, not of Manny Asuncion, but the place where it happened. There was blood all over their furniture were toppled down. But the usual narrative we've heard is nanlaban, nakipaglaban sila.
But what kind of outcome in reality are you expecting out of this? Given the fact, for instance, that there are also a lot of questions as to how earnestly law enforcers had investigated, for instance, the killings in Negros before. And now you have this latest round of killings as part of the police raids in the Calabarzon region.
Yes, we demand a full investigation. General Parlade cannot just simply say these were all legitimate operations. Our colleague in Bayan Muna, Attorney Caloy Zarate, in previous hearings, demanded that there should be a procedure required in the military operations, police operations, that if there is any death, there must be a investigation from the PNP itself to account for what actually happened. And similarly, in the Tokhang incidents, of thousands of supposed operations, 6,000 deaths officially by the PNP, only about 200 had investigations done. So we demand a full investigation from the PNP, from the military, on these operations. And these are required SOPs or standard operating procedures that the PNP has failed to do.
How about a congressional investigation coming from the House of Representatives? Are you also going to push for this?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we're already preparing a resolution to have this investigated. We cannot just have killing sprees. We cannot have just every Sunday, bloody Sundays. Like what you mentioned, this has happened in Negros and many other parts of the country. And we cannot just simply sit back, business as usual, while deaths attributed, by the way, to the pandemic. We cannot have more pandemics. We cannot have more deaths through this these actions of the government. So we will also file a resolution to have this investigated and call on the leadership of the House of Representatives to hopefully address these concerns. These massacres, almost daily, almost weekly, or monthly, cannot continue.
Okay, Bayan Muna Representative Ferdinand Gaite, thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you to all of you.